Do people around you use LLMs for everything, but when you try it yourself, the output is just wrong? Maybe your industry is too niche, or your tasks are oddly specific. Let's talk about how to train LLMs to fit your needs. There are two ways you can make LLMs more tailored to your tasks, either training or fine-tuning. Training is like building an LLM's knowledge from scratch. It involves setting model weights and optimizing on large datasets. Generally, it requires a lot of resources and advanced technical knowledge. Meanwhile, fine-tuning begins with a pre-trained base model and adapts it using your specific data. But when should you choose each strategy? The answer is simple. Go with training when you need a LLM for a wide range of tasks or if you have a massive amount of data to process. But if it's for a less complex project, fine-tuning will do the job. By the way, fine-tuning isn't always needed either. Can good prompting solve 80% of your problem? If yes, stop here. Fine-tuning won't magically fix what prompts can do. Now, what's needed for LLM training or fine-tuning? There are two ingredients: training data and technical infrastructure. Let's talk about data first. There is no magic number for how much data you need. It depends on your task complexity and model size. What we know is that you can achieve good results with surprisingly little data. But here's the catch. Quality is everything. So what defines quality data? First, consistency is king. Every example should follow the same exact format. Second, diversity within constraints. Cover edge cases and different phrasings, but stay consistent in structure. Third, clean beats comprehensive. Start small with perfect examples and scale up. Recent studies show that using smaller, high-quality subsets can outperform using all available data. Another requirement for LLM fine-tuning or training is technical infrastructure. For this, you'll need access to GPU or TPU clusters, sufficient storage or cloud services, and framework like Hugging Face transformers or TensorFlow. Even with the right infrastructure, training or fine-tuning an LLM might seem complex, but it's a lot more manageable when broken into small steps. I'll walk you through the process. Step 1. Define your goals. What do you want your model to do? Chat with customers, summarize documents, be specific. Once your AI goals is set, you'll need to choose performance metrics. Common metrics include accuracy or how often the model gets it right, latency or how fast it responds, and clarity or how easy its outputs are to understand. Then, it's time to collect and prepare your data. You can gather this manually using web scraping tools or buy pre-made datasets. Just keep your training and validation datasets separate, or you'll get misleadingly good results. If you are using web data, make sure to parse it and standardize it for use. In this step, ready-made scrapers with built-in parsing feature will save you lots of time. Step 3. Choose your base model. For most projects, something like Llama 2.7 billion offers a good balance of performance and resource requirements. But if you're building a high-traffic application or need fast performance, you might consider larger models like GPT-4.1. Step 4. Set up your environment. Install Python, PyTorch or TensorFlow, Hugging Face transformers, and tracking tools like weights and biases. Keep it version controlled and reproducible. You'll thank yourself later. Next, tokenize your data. Models don't read text, they parse tokens. Use a tokenizer that matches your model architecture. For example, you can use GPT-2 tokenizer for GPT-style models. Step 6. Train or fine-tune the model. Configure your learning rate, batch size, and other hyperparameters. Think of these as the model's learning settings, how quickly it learns, and how much data it processes. Just don't pick random values. Experiment with different settings and iterate. Fine-tuning is rarely perfect on the first try. Start small with a limited sample to catch issues early. Step 7. Evaluate and validate. Choose metrics aligned with your task. F1 for classification, Rouge for summarization, Blue for translation, or Perplexity for language modeling. Monitor your model during training using that separate validation set. Watch for overfitting. When your training accuracy looks great because the model learns the data itself, but not the underlying patterns. That means it's time to stop or adjust. Don't just rely on numbers. Instead, test with real prompts. Finally, deploy and monitor. Use Fast API or Flask to serve your model. Set up tracking for latency, quality, and usage patterns. Ready to collect the data you need for LLM training? Try Decodo's web scraping API with a 7-day free trial. Check the link in the description, and I'll see you next time.